Let's check on European markets first. They are down in afternoon trade as market sentiment remains unnerved by Trump's tariff threat. The German DAX lower by 0.6%, while the French CAC 40 is seeing wider losses at 1.3%. Over on Wall Street, futures are also pointing to a negative open, with traders bracing for the release of the Fed's preferred inflation measure, the PCE price index. It's also the last trading day before Wall Street goes on a one-day break on Thursday for the start of the Thanksgiving holiday.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Just Eat Takeaway, which announced its plan to delist from the London Stock Exchange next month in a blow to the UK's ambitions to attract more tech firms to its local bourse. London-listed shares of the Dutch food delivery company last traded lower by 1.4%. Also in focus, shares of Dell after the company's fourth quarter guidance fell short of Wall Street expectations. Shares of the tech company plunged nearly 13% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on HP after it reported weaker than expected earnings guidance for its fiscal 2025 first quarter. HP shares sank 9% on the news.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade on a mixed note. The Nikkei 225 led underperformers hit by a stronger yen. The safe haven currency climbed to a three-week high against the U.S. dollar, which fell on the back of sagging treasury yields ahead of the PCE price index data. Meanwhile, Chinese markets shined even as data showed China's industrial profits plunged 10% in October. As for the local bourse, the PSEI posted a second day of losses, with decliners beating advancers 2-1.
In that respect, maybe I'm a little bit more positive. We've heard all the bad news has come out. Okay. And, take a look at the PSEI companies. There are quite a few that should lead the growth and, appreciate and an appreciation of the index over December. Maybe if we keep it to just that time frame. So infrastructure companies will be there. That will always be positive. The power companies, still positive in that respect. And the consumer companies. Maybe people are doing late consumption, but we hope that we will see the spike in December.
A notable stock move within the region, shares of Samsung tumbled nearly 3.5% as the tech giant announced leadership changes in its memory and foundry chip units. That's as it struggles to catch up to SK Hynix and TSMC in the booming AI chip market.
Here are some local corporate headlines. PLDT unveils its new hybrid modem, which is said is the first of its kind in the world. The fiber always-on device offers uninterruptible internet connection, automatically shifting from fiber to LTE if there are fiber cuts or service interruptions. The telco giant will offer the new modem as an add-on, but it hopes to make it the standard device by next year.
Think of it as like an insurance plan. Diba? We have an insurance premium that we pay every month. This one, as soon as your fiber connectivity dies, then you will have insurance in the form of connectivity via LTE only for 299 pesos a month.
Meanwhile, the Aboitiz Group bags its third airport deal with the Bohol Panglao International Airport. The proposed 4.5 billion peso project for the country's ninth busiest gateway involves expanding the passenger terminal building, installing essential equipment, and modernizing airside and landside facilities. Aboitiz aims to boost the Bohol Airport's capacity to 3.9 million passengers by 2030. And finally, ASEAN's Vietnam unit is buying 49% of BIM Energy Holdings from Huntington Renewable Investments for $70.5 million. The deal will allow ASEAN to increase its pipeline projects in Vietnam. BIM has interest in several ASEAN projects such as the 405-megawatt Ninh Thuan Solar and 88-megawatt Ninh Thuan Wind projects.